Live.
Oh no! Ah! Well, I hope you didn't expect much more than me dropping the camera all over the place. Tonight is a special night. Tonight, we're not only building an aquarium live for the first time, but we're doing it on YouTube as well as Twitch. I was kind of streaming over on Twitch first because I was doing kind of the boring part, which is peeling back the acrylic. Tamara's going to help me. And unfortunately for Twitch, they already heard all this, but you guys are going to hear everything that I already had said. Let's see here. Yeah, you'll figure out how to do live chat. So when the chat goes away, what's up, NC Discus, Harsh Varma, Mr. Zane, Joey for president, thank you. You can go, you press the comments and they'll come up. Tamara's going to, she told me, she's like, what do I say if somebody has a question or something like that? I'm like, well, if I'm talking and I'm explaining something, don't interrupt me unless it's a super chat. So if you guys are super chatting, you'll automatically get to make me shut up. And I know how many people want to make me shut up. Tamara's right here. She'll be holding it. Absolutely stunning. Gentlemen, this is the only times you'll be in her hands. So appreciate it. Or don't. But okay, we're gonna start from the beginning and I'm gonna walk you through how to build an acrylic aquarium, and we're doing it live. The purpose of doing this live is very simple. I think that many people are incredibly intimidated and also scared of building their own fish tank. I'm going to do it live. I'm going to show you how to do it. I have tutorials coming out. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the other things that I have to admit is that many of you have been watching my videos that I filmed a month ago. I've already built the tanks, all of the things. I also need to address my grievances because a month of videos have come out and I've seen your comments and stuff and I really wanted to reply to them, but I didn't have an opportunity because, well, the videos, the next, you know, 8-10 videos are coming out. The reason why I had to film in advance is obviously we're going from 6 tanks to 35 tanks in the aquarium gallery alone. And I really need to focus, and I really want to concentrate. And I didn't, if I'm being fully honest, I didn't want views or what's working and what's not to impact my decision. Yeah, you just flip it that way. You got it?
I got it.
So, can you see me?
You can see you, yeah.
All right. So, I also have... and Twitch already knows, but I also have a huge announcement to make. And it's not your average announcement. It's not even, what have I announced before? You know, some big announcements that I've made is I wrote a book, what we'll talk about right now is I'm going to be in Atlanta, Georgia next month doing a presentation. It's a good one. It'll never be filmed, it'll never be on video or anything like that. I truly believe in being a real creator. I don't like to recycle talks. I only like to do them once. If I wanted to, I'd just put them on YouTube, like instead of traveling. Traveling's hard for me, especially with my location. So for me to go anywhere in the United States, I've got to go to Toronto first, which is a 3-hour flight. And then I have to do at least one connection flight. It's an absolute nightmare, and I don't like it. However, I just got back from Ohio. Well, damn near a month ago. Well, it was more than a month ago. I went to Ohio Fish Rescue. I got to be Rich. I needed that. I needed to meet Rich. I needed to know that whatever you see on the internet doesn't necessarily mean it's real. Meeting him in person, it was like I went down there, we filmed some stuff. It wasn't filmed in the order that you think, but we just had so much fun with each other, and getting to talk and being around somebody who's like-minded and passionate, that it was just so refreshing, so energizing, and so inspiring. You guys gotta know what I mean when you meet a fellow fish keeper that's like really into the stuff that you're into. Meanwhile, I've been trapped at home for all these years. And anything that I have done, I've gone to the big conventions. And the big conventions are just money-making things. They don't care about the hobby or the average fish keeper. Let's just make things as big as possible, you know, and make as much money. And I fell for it. I was like, well, if I go to the big conventions, I can kill so many birds with one stone and meet so many people. But they were just like hollow interactions. It wasn't for me. I go back to the clubs where I started. That's where I started. I used to be an aquarium hobbyist, and I joined my local club. I became a member. I got on the board of directors. Then I became vice president, and then I became president. Mind you, this was years ago. I have a respectable history in the hobby that I'm proud of. I never got into it to start a store. I never got into it because I saw a YouTuber and I thought I could make money doing that. I got into doing what I'm doing for the absolute right reasons. Can they hear me on there?
I think so. Everyone seems to be, yeah. Can you guys hear him? Just give me a comment if you can hear him.
On here.
Yep, audio's great.
Okay. The trip to Ohio, I absolutely needed. I came home and I hit the ground running in terms of like, not only what I want to do for YouTube and what I want to do for myself and my hobby, and what I truly want my legacy to be. And some ideas that I have that could potentially change your hobby forever. I know that I've had an impact, and I know I'm not allowed to talk about a lot of the stuff that I've done for the industry and or hobbyists because I'm arrogant or cocky or whatever, so I'm not even gonna get into that stuff, but Joey's got a new idea. Joey's got an absolutely phenomenal idea that's going to come from my heart.
Super chat.
Oh no.
$2, you must, who is it?
$2 isn't enough to shut me up. It's a toonie.
Aspinwall Family Homestead. You must like those big work lights beside you.
Those LOL.
Work lights beside you.
Okay, let me address a grievance, and then I'm going to start building this. My grievance is there's only really been one where I saw backlash in my videos. And you guys know I like a little bit of drama. I like to capitalize on it because I can make a drama video. I don't do it a lot. You know, my response, I've done three of them. My response to live feeding 5 or 6 years ago. My response to Fish Gone, and my response to the Aquarium Gallery. Well, this is my response for the first time live to this desk. I know you hate it, and that's my fault because I didn't explain it properly to you. I want you to consider something. As I stand here, I want you to see where my elbows are. It is the perfect standing desk. I needed a workstation to build these tanks. When I need to sit down, I sit on my cute little stool, my cute little bum, and I sit right like this, and I click away. And that's it. That's what I don't look at my actual bum.
I was just showing that you have room for your legs and stuff.
Oh yeah, I never sit like this. And even if I do, I just move the desk. But I could have made this lip and people's like make it a few inches wider. And I thought about that originally, but then I thought, well, I love this space. I love how open it is out here. I'm doing things specifically for specific feel and vibe, yet we're packing in 35 tanks. And the max at one point that the gallery has ever had at its height was 12. Now we have twice as many gallons and twice as many fish, yet twice as much room. So there was a compromise. Do I make this desk to be practical, or should I make it so that it's okay to sit at? Again, that's my fault for not explaining that in the video. I am the villain. And my apologies entirely and completely. All right. Joint, you're going to have to come a little closer. And you're going to have to look down. When building an acrylic aquarium, a lot of the times it comes down to prep. I'm not going to run through absolutely every aspect of it. However, we're going to go over the basics and tips and tricks that I think that you will find incredibly useful. Mind you, if you think you're never gonna build one because you don't know where to get the acrylic for, or you don't know how to get it cut, you don't know dimensions or anything, save that for a few minutes from now. We're gonna have a chat. We're going to announce something. And the reason I'm going to announce it is because I have to say it out loud or it's not gonna happen. First and foremost, these are some plywood blocks. These are the key to building a square acrylic aquarium. It's four pieces of plywood, and you'll notice that the edges are enough to fit 10 millimeter thick acrylic, which is what this is. What this allows me to do, and I'll use this one, it'll be a better example. What this allows me to do is square things up. Look, see how it sits there in that groove? Now, I can take a piece of acrylic, and one of the things when you're cementing something is it's falling all over, it's tipping. Is it square? I already know this is square. So look, I'll put it in this groove and I'll close this. Watch this. So it's considered a square jig. There's so many different types of squares you can use. I can give you some more examples on ideas and things that you can do. But this is the easiest. And of course, it also makes sure it's lined up perfectly. Perfectly square. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So you don't have plywood, you don't have a saw. Let me give you another idea. Stay right there. We're gonna take a couple little clamps. Mind you, if this video is too raw for you, I have a full tutorial video coming out on exactly how to do this. I think I used four cameras to film it. We're gonna get a square. This is aluminum, because aluminum doesn't stick to acrylic. We're gonna square up the edges here. Take some tiny little clamps. These were 99 cents. The clamp was $5. I gotta do it over here so I can. But you see how it's the lip? So typically you would square it up like this, because of the base, but for my purposes, I'm going to square it up like this, clamp it in place. You know, a couple clamps just to make it really good. Same idea, cheaper, but I like this more because it's heavy. Because watch, I can still tip it. I'm not a fan of that. Of course, maybe I could put like a aluminum rod through here and weigh it down. I have a saw, I bought the plywood, and I just made new ones. There's a number of ways you can do this. And contrary to what's going on the internet right now, there's more than one way to do something, especially when it comes to aquariums. Just because it doesn't work for one person does not mean it won't work for you. Here's an interesting fact. So I'm just going ahead and trying to put things together for you right now. I like to do things on the edge, at least the first corner. I don't know why, it's just how I do it. But imagine with me for a moment. Twitch can't see me. So imagine with me, and you'll understand, all of these steps are important. This panel's the first panel that I'm going to put on to this panel, but what is this panel once the aquarium's built? I want you to imagine your fish tank, the front panel and the side panel. You know the side panel's on the inside, don't you? This is my front panel. This is my side panel. Acrylic aquariums at a hobbyist level.
Super chat.
Oh Lord, what is it?
$5, Pedro Lewis Roman. Just wanted to hear Tamara yell, super chat.
Don't make that a thing, guys. Because like I said, I was talking, and that what was his name, Super Roman?
Pedro Lewis Roman.
Pedro Lewis Roman, I will forever hate you. Okay, so the inside goes on the front panel. This one's gonna go on, and then this one's gonna go on. Then we flip it, and we put this onto another panel. We'll see in a few minutes. But again, we're doing it live. We're not edited. I know that like a lot of YouTubers build fish tanks and a glass, plywood. I congratulate them, and I'm happy I taught you well, but for the ones that are that have leaking ones, pay closer attention, because my tanks don't leak. They won't always be pretty, but they do not leak. I overbuild them, because I don't want them to leak. Yeah, I've seen some YouTubers building fish tanks, and they're experts, and because they've done it once, they're like, this is a tutorial, and then like a week later, it's leaking, or they got to take it apart, or whatever. I'm like, okay, maybe when you're doing tutorials on things that could explode, maybe when you're doing, Twitch can't see me. Maybe when you're doing a video where you could damage somebody's entire property, and cause them tens of thousands of dollars in damages, maybe you shouldn't do a tutorial until you've done it many, 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 many times. But that's what I do. I've done these many, 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 many times. I'm comfortable with my ability and able to do it live. And even having some apple juice while I do it. Mind you, it is Saturday. I am a grown man. I kind of wanted to have some apple juice, and I had a couple, and then I was like, you know what? Let's go live and build a fish tank. And not because I've never done it. That's a fun little sales pitch. It's because so many people are scared of it. And I got to remove that from them. We're going to take some bobby pins. If you're into sewing, like I'm not, just get these from your local sewing pin location, like craft store, yeah. We're going to be using the pin method. This is one of the most tried and true methods that you're going to want to do. Come on over here. Come on. We're going to take this and we're going to put it under here. I also like these heavy plywood blocks simply because, well, you guys watched me move this entire system.
Coffee bean. $2. Tamara, yell. Super chat.
No more $2 ones. It's got to be $5 and up. I got to have standards.
Okay. He's setting boundaries, guys.
Yeah, they're going to be pissed. They're going to be like, $2? Ain't nobody got money for that. No, let them do $2, too. Screw it. Not everybody has $5. Not in this economy, Tamara. That's true. Tamara, yell super chat. Somebody, Coffee Bean. Oh, gosh. Is that, that's on YouTube, yeah? Okay. All right. Ready? So, we're going to be using a solvent called Weld-On-4. This is a massive amount of solvent. I won't even use this, but I'd rather have too much than not enough. This is an applicator bottle that you can buy when you're buying this type of thing. I'm not a huge fan of it, because there's not a lot of control to it, but you can see how it comes out. I don't care, squirt it. You don't want to squirt it on a wood surface, but it is.
Super chat. Aspenwell Family Homestead, $10, LOL. Super chat? Question mark? Dot, 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 dot.
So now you're a meme.
It's become a trolling session.
Yes, it's now a troll. I hate it. Okay, thank you. I appreciate it. I just squirted $10 worth of solvent on the floor. You covered it. I appreciate that. No, this rack is going to be about, I'm putting about $10,000 into it. And then the new tanks that I got, 12 of them, they're here. You're going to see that video tomorrow that I filmed a month ago. That's going to be at least $10,000 to $15,000. Then the building that, we'll get to that later. Ladies and gentlemen, we got some news. And anyways, this is a solvent. It's called a cement, of course, because when you think about cement, you're kind of gluing two things together, and that's not technically what happens. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to fill in that gap between what I just lifted up. The needles are going to allow me, and you can use anything. Some people like to use the needles of the applicator, which is a little bit skinnier and probably would be a little bit better, but these bottles are $3.99 versus this 100 pins was, what, $3 or $4? No, we got it from Michael's, so it was like $48 or something. They're overpriced. No, it was like $5. We're going to squirt the cement in there. We'll call it cement. And what's actually going to happen, though, is it's going to soften the acrylic to the point where it fuses together at a molecular level. What will be left after 3 to 5 minutes is a seam that basically just melted the, it's like welding. That's what it's called, weld-on. It fuses the acrylic at a molecular level. It softens it up till it kind of glues, like melts together. And it goes down to a molecular level. And then the solvent evaporates. However, when you're working with acrylic that's thinner than 10 millimeter, you're typically gonna wanna go with the wicking method. And wicking, which is, you'll see exactly how that works in a second. Wicking means there's nothing in between it. And when we put the cement along the seam, it sucks into it. It's also called the capillary method because it's a capillary action where the water just, water or solvent or whatever, just wicks into that seam. Now that you watched me peel back all that protective film, the next thing is prep. I'm gonna bring Twitch in a little bit closer. I think this is close as I can go. All right. Now, it's just squaring it up. I already know that these blocks are gonna square it up, but I want it down to, you can use a square, you can use whatever tools or materials you like. I like to go by touch. I like to know that I can't feel anything. I want this seam to feel like when I rub my finger along this, I want it to feel like that there too. I also don't necessarily care if there's a bit of a lip here because I can route that off. Acrylic comes down to, if you have tools to cut wood and route wood, and you can work with acrylic. Use the same saw blades, you use the same tools, you use the same everything. And now for the oddly satisfying moment. So if you come in, Tamara, you can kind of look in. Let me see what the camera looks like. Okay, yeah, so hold it there.
Super chat, Andrew Borschers, $20. Joey, sing soft kitty, LOL.
Joey, say what?
Sing Soft Kitty, LOL.
Sing Soft Kitty?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know that song. So watch, I'm going to squirt it into that seam. Look how it turns at a different, it basically makes it just look wet. Let me just keep going. Can you see it changing on the camera?
Yep.
So we're just squirting it in. Now, the fixturing or the working time is about 60 seconds. And what that means is I have 60 seconds to make, and pardon my French, but to make damn sure that everything's squared up properly. And this is perfect. So now I'll wait about 60 seconds before I pull these pins. When I know I should pull these pins, I'll show you in a minute. A little bit of cement's coming out of here, and this stuff feels like and smells like rubbing alcohol. So you know, when you get some rubbing alcohol on you, wait 2 seconds or 30 seconds or whatever, and it evaporates. This works essentially the same. But what I'm looking for right now is not happening. But it's also a good time that if you didn't get enough acrylic in the seam, go ahead and chuck a little bit more in. This isn't going to be a big deal. I'm going to actually leave this to prove a point. There's a tiny bit here it's not enough. But in a minute, it's not going to matter.
Super chat, Odin Hammer, $2.79. Just introduced my mother. You need more hair, LOL.
Oh, I need more hair on my head? Do you want the story on why I don't have hair? When I was younger, and when I was 25 years old, which I'm only 26 right now, that's the first time I ever appeared on camera. And at that point, when you're a man or a male, if you don't like your hair, you can start over. You just go, shave it off, and you start over, and you grow new hair, and you do what you want. When I was 25, for the first time I appeared on camera, it was the next day after I was starting over. But it was also the first time I appeared on camera on YouTube, and I was worried about branding and, you know, and I thought, I really love what I'm doing, However, I want people to know it's me when they see me, so I'm just gonna look the same forever. And for the last 15 years, I've shaved my head because I did it for the first time on camera. If that's not commitment. Mind you, a couple years ago, I tried to grow my hair and I ended up getting rid of it. Vice grips or whatever to pull these out. You can use your fingers at times. Look, it just squishes down. Look at that. So, like I said, can you see the goo?
Yes.
That's acrylic. So that was a little bit more than a minute, but of course but yeah, that's why I have a shaved head to this day. My identity as a human being and as a person is so embedded in YouTube. I often think about, like, when will I stop, when will I give up, or when will I... And I've said things that were melodramatic, like, I will give up YouTube when I hit full circle, when nobody's watching me again, when I'm getting 10 views on my videos or whatever. Just like how I began the first 2-3 years of me making videos. Nobody watched, nobody cared, but I don't think anybody took social media seriously, and nobody was really watching and that sort of thing, but... So I thought, that's what I'll do in full circle. And I think these days, YouTube's just a huge part of who I am. Right down to why I cut my hair the way I cut it. So, yeah. How's the chat on YouTube doing? Are they saying anything else?
Yeah, lots of people are saying things. There's a thousand people watching.
Questions. So anybody with a red... This, mm-hmm. That's the same as a super chat to me.
Okay.
That means they've been a member of the channel for like 2 years or 3 years, so they're automatically promoted. Try not to show that stuff. That's daddy's apple juice. YouTube doesn't like that stuff. We're gonna wait about 5 minutes, and then we're gonna move on to the next step.
Super chat. $5, Chris Sutton. Hey Joey, just wanted to say thanks. I used your build a cheap filter video to make a skimmer out of a gallon jug and used it on my 125 gallon tank.
Skimmer, surface skimmer or protein skimmer?
Super chat, heavy AF underscore deuce, $5. Do you have acrylic tank instructions in your book?
Yes. The book. And I don't like the reference to it. It's why I shut down my my P.O. box where you guys used to get to send me things. I never said it, but the things that I was getting into my P.O. box became too political, too religious, and too sexual. So I was like, I can't unbox this stuff. I was still getting nice things, but I shut it down because I was like, people are trying to like push an agenda onto me. With that said, what's prompting this is a lot of people call, and I hear it continuously, is the do-it-yourself, the ultimate do-it-yourself handbook for the do-it-yourself aquarist is the Bible of the aquarium hobby. I like the reference, but in today's world, like, Lord knows who will offend, like, saying that. I like that reference. I'm very proud of hearing that. I'm very proud of when, like, people think that. With that said, the person that wrote that book no longer exists. That was a genius filled with so many things and so many thoughts and information that he like couldn't wait to get it out. And it all happened. I don't want to devalue the book, but I'm going to tell you a story.
Hua also said, Daddy's apple juice, ? And a super chat from Andre, $10. And he sent an animated sticker.
So this is the book. Thanks for the sticker. And and whatnot, but the members, I like to make sure they get a little bit more attention as well. This is the book I'm talking about. It's not a flex, and I'm not trying to get you to buy it. It's sold plenty. I published it in 2013. It's not like it's a new book where I need everybody to get it. It's done its duty. However, sometimes people are like, wow, how do you know so much, or you do so much, or... How do you know this? And you know, it's all I care about. It's all I know. And, you know, if you want to talk about anything else, I won't know anything. But imagine you're at work and somebody asks you, how do you do this? You can spit it out off the top of your head, like, immediately, without even thinking. And that's what this was. It was just so easy for me. However, once I started, I wrote the index. That's how I began this book, the index. I wrote out the index and what I was going to talk about. Yeah, the index is a lot because it's a 552-page book. Again, not a sales pitch. And this will devalue...
Super chat, cellar door, $10, apple juice funds.
Thank you. You know I like my apple juice. I sat down and within 3 weeks, I wrote, edited, self-published, and distributed this book. I didn't eat much, I didn't sleep much. It was one of the most exciting things I had ever done, yet terrifying because I didn't think anybody would buy it. Boy, was I wrong. So are things like this in the book? Yes. Just in greater detail and greater numbers and just a better writing. The chapter on filtration is by far my favorite chapter, and I'm going to be abundantly honest, I still look back on it and revert to it to see if I'm... Why do I have three of these? An aquarium doesn't have three socks. Is that extra? What, extra acrylic to do extra things? So I think it's been about 5 minutes. The fixturing time is over. So I can move this.
Super chat, Lewis Elsfin, $6.99. Thanks for your work. Just wanted to help in a small way. Keep up the good work, apple juice funds.
I don't know if Rich is in the YouTube chat. Sometimes he doesn't show up or whatever. I don't know if you have it on live chat or top chat, but if your chat, if you're saying something and I don't see it or respond to it, it doesn't mean that I'm ignoring you. It means that like the YouTube algorithm just chooses what to place there.
Another super chat from J.Ro Ortega. He didn't say anything. And Mike Martinez, another...
How much was the Ortega?
$5 and another $5 from Mike. What do you think of framing a tank with wood and lining it with acrylic so you can use thinner acrylic?
I think it's an interesting concept.
A 10K-gallon build in Florida made me curious.
I think that it's an interesting concept. Oh, I blocked it from YouTube, but not you guys. I think it's an interesting concept. I think that what a lot of people don't account for is one of the drawbacks to acrylic is it does absorb water. Now, what happens when you have something stiff and it absorbs water? It gets a little bit more flexible. So that's something that you also have to account for. The benefits, of course, to acrylic are its clarity. It's transmission of light. Its optical distortion is less than glass. But one of the things that I like that not a lot of people talk about is the heat transmission of acrylic is like 1.6 times more than glass. Meaning that when you're rating how fast heat can travel through a material, you can compare it to other things. And when it comes to glass, heat will travel faster, 1.6 times faster through glass than acrylic. Its insulative properties are far greater. Not only is it more impact resistant, the one thing we talk about when it comes to acrylic is it's easy to scratch. With what? Nails? Like literally nails? It can be scratched, of course, just like glass can be scratched, but we can remove the scratches from acrylic where it becomes virtually impossible to do it with acrylic.
Chris did a super chat. Would you consider another flower horn? P.S. I want your book. Any discount code available?
Yes. There is a massive discount code that I entirely and thoroughly regret. So the reason why the book costs $60 to begin with is I self-distribute. I self-publish, I do everything by myself. I answer to nobody, which allows me to talk the way I do and not worry about like a sponsor or a publisher or somebody like pulling out for me. There's never been a sponsor or anybody that pulled out for me. I pull out from them. And it's usually pretty extreme when I do. With that said, can we say pandemic?
I don't know, I feel like probably by now.
Okay, I can say pandemic, I just can't say the word, it's fine. Before that, my cost on the book dropped substantially. And the day it did, I waited a week to make sure that it was a stable drop. And I'm talking in shipping and production costs. The book went from $75 to $60. So I was still making around $20 a copy. And then once the thing happened, the costs went through the roof and they've stayed there ever since. So I'm not making money, but it's very close to breaking even, depending on where you are. I offer it worldwide. However, if you're buying it in Asian countries, I'll ship it, but I cringe because I'm paying you to have that book. If you know what I'm talking about, is that the expenses are too expensive. What I could do is raise the price back up to $75 and then give you a code to bring it down to $60. The other option is to join the members only and they get 20% off, which essentially means they get 3 months free at my expense, and that's hoping they stick around. The downside is you'll have to scroll around to find that code. You have to scroll down the community tab. You'll also have to put up with me spamming you sporadically, and it's not on a schedule. It's feast or famine as a member of this channel and becoming an OnlyFans or joining my OnlyFans. You will get nothing, or you're going to get spammed with videos, after pictures, after like my sporadic ideas. Lord forbid you join the Discord, because then I have Joey's thoughts, my own thing. You can't reply. I just like whatever I'm thinking about or I'm thinking about doing. I talked to them. So they've known about a lot of things I'm doing for about a year now.
Super chat as well from LKB Pythons, $2 Apple Juice funds. It is. Fist bump.
I'm just refreshing.
J-Row Ortega, $5. Got your book a few years ago, built and used almost all DIY
thanks
filters.
Around,
thanks, Joey.
That is Apple Juice. That's hilarious. we're almost to the sub goal. Four more subs on Twitch. So I'm live on Twitch as well. You guys have always wanted me to live stream my my aquariums, and I do it on there. I'm not a huge fan of live streaming it, but it's like we're listening to an encyclopedia. Neo_Africa. Yeah, this is one of the only things that I'm good at. So when I'm criticized, people criticize me as a person. In terms of like, oh, he's cocky and arrogant. You damn right I am. Because you know why I am? I'm teaching people how to build things that could explode in their house. I need to be confident. I need to know exactly what the hell I'm talking about. Nobody criticizes my fish keeping. I wish they would. I'll respond on a video and pray you don't have videos because I'll bury you. I am being arrogant cocky because I talked to Rachel last night on the phone for about an hour. Was it last night?
Yep.
Last night, yeah. And we were talking about some of the most scientific things and talking about like some of the things that have come up lately about like you don't need to do water changes because the nitrates aren't that bad. And we talked about like real things. And we both agreed like, I think that people are just trying to be the next new idea, but it's coming at a dangerous expense. And maybe that's, I told her, I was like, I gotta make a video on this because it's dangerous for people to say that you could do something universally, damn near across an entire freshwater hobby with no consequences or repercussions. And I definitely don't agree with that. I just don't want to attack anybody or say names, or there are no names. It's more of a conversation. I was gonna sneeze, and I've never sneezed on camera before. I don't want them to see how cute I am when I sneeze. Thankfully, I shut down the P.O. box because it'd be flooded with panties, especially if they heard me sneezing. I'm joking. You're not even laughing, so I get no response, so sometimes I can see the live chat. You're just looking at me like this.
I'm just trying to hold the camera still.
So we've waited about 5 minutes and I was able to move that around over there. Technically, I don't need the end to be here. This tank could be on that, like pushed down on the side of the tank. I just like to be here. The other option is to spin it this way, but they hang over. And the problem with acrylic is its tensile strength isn't as high. Well, it's higher than glass, technically, but it's more flexible. Tensile strength means how much pressure it takes to break it in half. And when it comes to acrylic versus glass, acrylic has a far higher tensile strength. You know what the problem is, though?
I do not.
Acrylic for me is so expensive right now. It's not cheap like it used to be. It used to be the cheapest material I could buy and build a nice tank, and now it's become more expensive than glass. But I think it's easier to build an acrylic aquarium than it is to build a glass aquarium. I think it's easier to build, it's damn near as easy to build, well, plywood tanks allow for the greatest amount of mistakes. Glass aquariums are second, because that's what I worry about, like how many mistakes can I build? With an acrylic aquarium, or sorry, with a glass aquarium, one of the things that you have to worry about is if you make a mistake on a glass aquarium putting it together, you have to wait till it cures and then take it completely apart. If you've ever taken apart a glass aquarium, that is the time when you will respect silicone for the first time. Sorry, I was mad at them. I was not mad at you guys. I would never get mad at you. You know that. Don't film me for everything. Look around like this or something. When I'm having my heartfelt conversations, no, I just gotta make sure everybody feels included. One of the things is like, I can't see anybody's chats, so I don't know if anybody's even liking the live stream because I feed off of it, but the next thing we gotta do is put on this next panel. We gotta do it right away. Do you wanna come in this way for this angle? No, like through here. So they can see exactly what I'm doing. Anything under 4 feet for an acrylic aquarium is abundantly easy. When you get to 4 feet and up, you're gonna have to start stressing about a number of other factors damn near out of your control. For example, if I build a 4 foot long tank, I have to worry if the surface is not only true and flat, but there is no bow to it. Any sort of bow, and I'm putting on the side panels or the front panels and backs, I mean, the acrylic is not going to meet. You're going to have a continuous and constant gap. That's it. So all that talking for this, all it was prep work. I don't know if Carrie's still in the chat, but her husband's looking to build a fish tank. And I was like, is kind of like, I'll admit, like that kind of inspired it too. I didn't get to talk to any fish keepers very much, but like he was nervous and, not nervous, but yeah, I guess he would call it nervous. He's an MMA fighter, so it's very unlikely that he's nervous about much at all, but he was worried like he'll screw it up. And I'm like, you know what? I got a video coming out, but I'll do it live. Not a lot of creators will do this because a lot of their videos are highly edited and kind of, to be fair, regurgitate what I've talked about.
Carrie said she's taking notes.
Well, the full feature video is far more educational and less banter. The mods for my DIY Fish Keepers group on Facebook, they're like, one of them, I think it was Al, he said, watch the Twitch, a lot of banter. I was like, I know it's a lot of banter because that's what I do. I can't shut up. Unless, of course, you are on the Super Chats, which you've allowed to shut me down. But I've been shut up for $5 or less tonight, and I feel like I'm worth a little bit more. I feel like I'm worth like $20, because there's not a lot of I wouldn't do for $20. Because if you, because like $20 is $20. So after about 60 seconds, I'm going to remove the pins out of here too. I can usually do it by my fingers and pull them out. But I've pulled the like little balls off so many times that I just go and grab vice grips or pliers. Pliers would be more ideal. But if you're like me, you have no idea where your measuring tape is, let alone your pliers, so you just grab whatever's going to work. And I like to use vice grips for darn near everything. And I'll use them to, when I'm close to using some sort of a tool, I don't know the name of many tools. This feels like it's like if you don't get any goo, but you get water, it's not done. But if you feel nothing, it's probably ready.
Odin Hamber, member for 27 months. LOL, does this count as a super chat?
Yes. I know Odin Hamber. Like, I know his name a lot. And that's one of the things that I miss about when my channel is smaller, is like, I could remember a lot of names, and they would come back, and you see them in the comments again. And the bigger you get, things have changed now because I haven't really been putting out as many videos. So the YouTube algorithm chewed me up and spit me out. But in January, we did 130,000 new subscribers, 33 million views or something like that. So that was nice to see. And it was very encouraging. I'll be honest, it was my dad moment where I was like, still got it. Yeah. Before that, the most subscribers we ever had in a month was, I think it was like 2017, 2018 in the summer. We did 60,000 subscribers and 10 million views or something. So to jump to over 30 million and to do double that subscribers was definitely a nice little reminder of like, Joey, keep going, keep pushing. Because you do need results sometimes. You do need a pat on the back. You do need to be told you're doing the right thing. At times, encouragement means a lot. We need 2 more subscribers on Twitch to hit my sub points. Is that what that is? What are my sub points? Left YouTube to be here. I've been watching Joey since he built the large square-based aquarium.
Super chat.
At least 10 years.
Pedro ago. Lewis Roman, $5.
Wild. Yeah.
Tamara say super chat, you'll remember my name. I do.
What was the name?
Pedro Lewis Roman. He did one earlier. And Scott DeLong, member for 18 months. Wait, this is not the nude stream, or that must be on OnlyFans.
I don't know what that means.
Lewis Elsfin, member for 21 months.
Yeah, well,
you still got it, dude.
Yeah, the picture quality is so much better. Why don't you do a little bit of Q&A while I use the washroom? And just flip the camera to you or whatever, and then that tripod will come out, and you can have a break here. I can do it for you.
You set it up. Ask me questions.
Hey guys.
I don't know the answer to.
1,000 people watching. Nice. You got all the super chats and stuff? That came out wrong. Sorry. Alien World Aquatics. Have you seen a UFO at the King of DIY? I have not, that I know of. I would love to think that we're not alone. I think that the universe is far too big to be that arrogant and think that we're not. Are there other planets that meet the requirements for life? If the universe is as big as they say, there has to be other life out there. How far behind or how far ahead are they? I don't know. I mean, we started out as bacteria. Yeah, and then we moved to fish at some point. We all come from fish, don't we? Like, I don't know for sure, but...
little swimmers.
All right, is that on you?
Yes.
Do you want another little set?
Yes. Please.
Right, so you answer that. If the viewers start dropping, you can look at the Brontë tank if you want or something. I don't know.
Ken and Lisa Adams, I've always enjoyed your content and I've seen all your videos. Keep the motivation going and enjoy it to the fullest.
I appreciate you guys. Thank you. Joey's OnlyFans. So guys, I'm going to go in the house. Like a gentleman, technically I'm just going to go out in the yard and use the bathroom. A number one, though. No, it's a number two. Out in the yard. And when we get back in, I have to do the most stressful part of building an acrylic aquarium. So make sure you stick around.
Hi, Odin Hamber. And $10 from Christina Watkins. Keep it up, Joey. Do you still get to enjoy your own hobbies? Do you mean me or Joey?
I don't have any hobbies. I guess I have gym and work.
Am I still competing and training dogs? Not really. I just train Luke now. But that's about it for me. Needed a bit of a break. What's my favorite apple juice? Anything that's like wine or vodka or rum. And what else do we got? Joey OnlyFans? No OnlyFans, just OnlyFans. Am I gonna do any tankscapes? Maybe. I don't know. I'll have to ask Joey. What's my favorite fish? Right now, my favorite fish is like a white koi that's in this 375 with an orange dot on its head. Have we set a date for the wedding? Not quite yet. I wanted it to be this summer in June, but there's a lot of things going on this year. Haley's graduating and her prom. So probably 2024 instead.
You guys just patiently sitting here waiting for me to come back.
Who's in my eyes? You guys have to be more... I didn't shower today. I was out doing a lot of yard work today.
I help Joey, and I do love going to the gym and working out, and that's pretty much my only hobby, but I take Luke for a lot of walks, too.
Tamara's hobby is being pretty, and you all know it.
Yeah, my new hobby is trying to learn how to do my own makeup, because I never really got into it before.
Two more sub-points. How do I change this?
What do you think of Joey spending all nights in the fish room? Usually I come out here and spend it out here with him, so I don't mind.
Until I kick her out.
Yeah, until I get kicked out. Till I get the boot. What's my least favorite fish? I don't really have a least favorite one.
You be careful with this chat. They will set you up. What's your least favorite? What do you hate the most about Joey? Don't tell them. All right, we've got to move on.
Okay, we're moving on. Wait. One more super chat. $10. Nanners. Hello. Setting up 125-gallon tank. One just runs under it left to right about one-third of a distance from the front of the tank. Just sits.
Okay, Joyce, that sounds like a question for me.
You're going to have to look at that one.
It sounds like a... Where'd it go?
You have to scroll up.
How far? Oh, you just tap the... Can you just tap that? Let me just do... Nanners. Setting up a 125-gallon aquarium, one joist runs under it, left to right, about one-third distance from the front of the tank. Joists sit on a beam that runs centered from back. Do I need more support? Thanks. Well, when you're putting on a 125-gallon aquarium, is going to weigh up close to about just the water-wise is going to weigh about 900 pounds. Tanks or homes are, you can do the math yourself, and we're going to do it right now. So your home, the standards, I believe, and somebody in chat can correct me, and feel free to correct me if I'm right or wrong or give the right number, but I believe it's 60 pounds per square foot. Your 125-gallon tank is about, 6 foot by 18 inches? So we're looking at six, how many square feet is that? Six, 18, it's about eight square feet, nine square feet. So you should be able to safely, without being on a floor joist, it's not enough. You have to be on the joist. So what you're saying is your tank is here and the joists are running along with it. That's probably worst case scenario. You usually want the joists to run this way. So this is your tank, and then the joists run this way. Because those floor joists hold obnoxious amounts of weight. Do I think it will hold it? Yes. Do I think it's gonna move around while you walk on it? Yes. I've had those types. It's terrifying. I think it'll hold it. I hope you have renter's insurance or home insurance, though. Can Paku and Piranha be together? I think maybe at a smaller size, yes. I think that Piranha are often found with Paku at a younger size when they are in the wild, simply because Piranha are not necessarily a flesh eater at a small size. They're more so of like scales and fins. But that Paku will be without scales and fins. Do I think you should get a Paku? No. I think that Rich has enough Paku and he doesn't want yours. He's got too many as it is. We have 1,000 people watching, 331 likes. Do you know how to run a live chat? I will throw you through the wall. No, don't clip that. Joey's abusive live stream beats Tamara. But yeah, I'll throw you through the wall. Is the camera on me right now?
It's on you. Clipped.
So, acrylic aquariums, I'll be honest, is more of a waiting game. If you're building like 7 in a day, which we still have to get to, I still have to tell you the plans and show you what it's going to look like, etc. But if you're building a lot in one go, you'll set your phone to a 60-second timer and what?
I was just making sure that one was also able to see you.
That wasn't even a super chat and you screwed me up. Anyways, this could happen a lot faster. We're an hour in and we have 2 panels on. It's not that much. We don't have enough done. But now things are going to get serious. This is why it's important to adhere to everything I'm saying. That 60 seconds, that 5 minutes, things like that, this is important. If you've never built an acrylic aquarium and you've never moved one, you're waiting 30 minutes on each scene before you do this. If I pull this up by itself, it's going to twist. I could break the seam. I don't trust that it's ready for this. We just flip it over at the same identical time. And now we're going to pick up the corners at the same identical time. And we're going to flip it. However, acrylic is soft and pliable. I can see the bend in this bending for that panel. So I'm going to take, whether it's another panel or whether it's a piece of wood or something that's at least 16 inches, and I'm going to put it in here. I'm going to make sure it's square. Not like that. But you'll notice it's stiff. It's not moving around. It's not easy to falling over. And the only reason that's happening is because the panel was bowing. That bowing bucks out the sides, and it's not a flat surface anymore over here. It'll kind of be. And the acrylic cement will trick you. Because once we put the acrylic cement in here and we have a bow, it's going to make it look like it's wet until you take out the pins, but it's not going to cure that way. You're going to have this tank, this back panel, like kind of bowed out. Is Carrie still here?
Carrie, are you still here?
Mind you, all of you guys are going to be able to do this in a minute. I still have to do the announcement. I still have to do like an absolutely insane announcement, and I don't care how successful it is. I don't care how much, you know, I make. I do. I want to make so much money. No. Yes, I do. No, I want to be like successful, but I don't. It's not the point of it. It's like I want to create something that doesn't exist, and I'm going to. No, I am. Do I need these blocks at this time? No. It's pretty much going to hold itself up. But do I add them anyway? Yeah. I mean, they could buck out. They could move around. And you guys see when I say buck out, like that side just fell to the ground. I don't want that to happen as I'm cementing this. One of the things I like to do though, I never use the same pin twice. They get covered in glue, they get gooey, Or maybe they'll have nothing on it, but it's that one time when you go to reach for a pin and it's all gooey and stuff and it messes up your seam to some extent.
Hua, nice capillary method. Can't beat it. Old tricks are the best tricks.
Who is a trick? There's some people that have been watching me for a long time and comment on every video. I'll always remember the names. And I'm a very loyal person. So it's very much so like, they're like my brothers and sisters. And I'd go to war for them. I've had longtime viewers that were like really taken advantage of with companies, and I personally called the companies because I know the owners of a lot of companies. And I'll be fair, they're scared of me. They're scared I'm going to make a video. And not like a video that like, oh, these people are bad, but I will tell the truth about a lot of things. So I've had, at times, longtime viewers contact me and say, Joey, I don't mean to put you in a tough spot, but this happened to me and that happened to me. I don't make videos about that. I don't need that type of publicity, but I always say less. I got you, and I fix it way better than they think. I don't do it as much anymore. Now that I've said I do that, or that I help people like that, I'm probably going to get flooded, but... like I said, like some people that have been watching me 10, 12 years type of deal, like it's tough for me not to protect them at all costs.
Lewis Effelson, I see you as a brother also, just on the other side of the country. Excuse me.
Yeah, I like meeting people too. Because they always, well... So when you meet me, there's a couple of things are going to happen. I'm just squaring things up. I'm just buying time because the next part is so fast and so easy. Let's just do it.
When you meet me, especially if you're coming to the Atlanta event,
which is free, that's a requirement for everything that I'm doing this year, is at no cost to you. You're not paying $89 or $129 to meet a fish keeper that you watch on the internet. It's just bizarre to me. When you meet me, a lot of people tell me how long they've been watching and which video. Or I've been watching you since XYZ video. And sometimes it's been like 2-3 years or 5-6 years, but every once in a while, as somebody that's been like watching me for 10 years, and I'm always like overwhelmed with emotion. And it's so exhausting, emotionally exhausting for me. It's so hard. It's very hard on me. Because at times you'll have imposter syndrome, and or especially as a creator, like you don't think you deserve to be where you're at or whatever the case might be, but it's just so nice to have people that truly love you and support you and are there for you no matter what. But one thing you can't be shy about, and all of a sudden people are shy to ask, is for a picture until they see like the lineup and everybody's getting a picture. If you don't get the picture, I will say, do you want to get a picture too? And they'll be like, oh, okay, yeah. Because a lot of people are shy about doing that. But what I will say is, for example, when I come to Atlanta, it's likely the last time I will ever get to meet you. And that picture is for both of us. Like maybe one day, if you post it, I go looking for my hashtags too. I'm not looking to see what people say about me. I'm looking to see who posted my picture. I love seeing it. And I remember, I'm like, oh yeah, I remember him. Oh, that's the guy that's got those laughed about this or that, or they keep this. And I love it. I really, truly enjoy it. But make no mistake about it, when I come to do these events, it's entirely and exclusively to see you. I do believe that aquarium clubs need our help more than ever. I don't think that I do the hobby justice by appearing at big events. I think my ego does it justice, but I have no reason to go there. The hobby needs us. The aquarium clubs need us. Your local fish store needs us. And we're going to come through.
Super chat Nick Myers, $4.99. Where would someone like myself source acrylic panels in the U.S. if it matters in the Midwest?
I don't know, but I'm going to solve that issue in about 20 minutes once I'm done building this. Be patient. What was his name?
Nick, I think.
Nick?
Gotcha, Nick.
I gotta own a house first. Yeah, that's one thing about my videos is like I own my property, I own my house, and I remember what it was like to like be a renter. You don't have tools. You don't have power saws and table saws because there's nowhere to put them. And since I've been living here for like 12 years, you get disconnected. You don't understand things as well as you did previously. You forget that like people don't have a table saw, Joey. They don't have the tools you have, Joey. And that's why a lot of people said, oh, I like your older videos better, because they were more relatable. Because I live in a house that you live in. I'm in a certain living condition similar to you. Not everybody owns a house, especially today. The cost of homes, the cost of everything. You know what used to, I'm gonna have to curse. You know what used to piss me off? I'd be renting a house and I'd be paying $750 a month on rent. That's equivalent to probably $2,300. Not a house either, like an apartment or whatever. Never missed a payment, did it for years, didn't go on my credit. But I can't get a loan? Where do you think I live, on the streets? I'm paying a lot of money every month. I don't know. I think that needs to be changed. I think that people should get credit for their living expenses and whatnot. I don't know. Maybe I'm alone. But I think it's crazy. But again, I'm disconnected. I am so disconnected a lot of times because I own my house and I have access. I can do whatever I want, and I have access to things that the average person doesn't. And I'm doing things that most people can't. And that's what I'm making videos about, and that's not how I started, and that's not why I got into the hobby, and that has nothing to do with why I started doing it, started DIY in the first place. But I'm telling you, this trip reinvigorated me. It opened my eyes back up. It made me realize, like, Joey, you are misguided. Your ambitions do not align with your core values or your morals. You need to make some changes. And I'm making them. I've got to put some weight on here because this is sliding around. And when it comes to acrylic aquariums, the more weight, the better. So maybe you have some free weights, or maybe you have some rocks. Anything that's heavy, if it's moving around, or if there's a bubble and it's too late, you've already cemented it, put some weights on it. These aren't heavy, but it's heavy enough. Like the pick, that might be 40 pounds, 30 pounds. Now we wait 5 minutes and then we do the last part, which is arguably worse. Does that say 403 likes?
It does, yeah. Gotta get them likes up.
Guys!
Hit that thumbs up button!
Help me! I hate, you know, like bagging and comment bagging, but it's like what the algorithm and things want, I think, and I guess. Obviously it's watch. I have no idea what YouTube wants anymore. I appreciate the likes. It makes me feel like I'm talking about the right thing because I can't see the chat, but I can see my boy, Sterling.
The likes are jumping up now.
Are they?
Yeah.
By how far? We need to get to it.
It's 535 now. 550.
700 likes? 750 likes? I finished this build with no pants on. I'm not going to actually do that. They love taking advantage of me too. Like, no. No, you will be doing with your pants.
You said.
All right. Where are we at on Twitch?
Canadian ice apple juice. Yeah. That's great, at least. Congrats. So on Twitch, they're having a conversation on their own. Oh, we met the sub goal. Thank you, guys. I think we actually did it. First time, chat. 100%, especially with the mortgage cost, it would be less than half what you pay on rent.
Super yeah. Chat, Sue Ann, $2. Hit that like button. Apple juice!
Where is my apple juice? Yeah, so it's, I think building this is an interesting thing to do. I think it's an interesting conversation to have. I can't wait for the announcement. And it's not even supposed to have. So, you guys know I work myself up. You guys know that I don't necessarily have announcements to make. But I thought we just might have to say a little something. I think I have to say what's on my mind. And the people that are live, I think I'm deleting this video too. Because if I announce it, I'm going to be hounded until it starts happening.
Vike said, I thought you couldn't stream on Twitch and YouTube at the same time.
Not from the same camera.
Hmm. Loopholes. Bullinator, $5, super chat.
What'd he say?
Didn't say anything.
What's the name?
Bullinator, 33.
Bullinator? Thank you. I used to go live on YouTube, and there'd be like 6,000, 7,000, 8,000 people watching, and the super chats would just fly in, and I was so lost in the idea that, like, it's not that I expected all of that to happen, but at that time, my channel was just, like, exploding and going super viral, and these days, I've just become so much more appreciative of, like, everything. Like, a $2 super chat. Like, man, nobody has any money anymore.
Super
right
chat,
now.
$2.
It's really
Husband
hard to do
Wall Family Homestead. New shirt, DIY apple juice. I think they're guessing.
Maybe I could do an OnlyFans version. I gotta launch them a shirt and give it to them at cost just to have it. But there's a link in the description to get my merch. Don't use it. I mean, it's there in case you can't wait. And I don't know when the new store is going to launch, but the new store is, this is older stuff. It's from the Signature Series, but the new stuff will cost you less, the shipping's less, but the material and the fabric and the quality, I want to say is 2-3 times more. You guys see me wearing that gray one? Not light gray, but like, is it like a dark gray? The material on that is just beautiful. You'll see what I mean eventually. But don't buy from the link in the description right now. Unless you want to get some old school stuff. But the new stuff is just night and day. And it's cheaper and it ships faster. And the shipping's cheaper. Yeah, I love it. I'll be right back. Switch the camera to you, man.
Back to me. Back to me, guys. I don't know where he went this time. He just took off on me. Ben would buy an OnlyFans shirt. What am I drinking? Some wine spritzer thing. It's not very good,
but
it's better than nothing. It's not horrible.
I think they were Gretons, but I can't remember. Can you guys hear me right now? Are those your shell dwellers at One Fish, Two Fish? No. No, I still have mine. I can't wait to tell that
story. Can we get an update on the new building?
Yes.
Yes. That update is coming.
That's not even the announcement. No, the announcement is for you. The announcement is you benefit directly. The announcement is something people have wanted me to do since the inception of my channel. Oh, should I talk about, is the camera on me?
Let me spin it around here.
So
I'm going to talk about a few things in this live stream, especially for the ones that have stuck around, especially on Twitch, and as well as here on YouTube. We're going to talk about things that nobody else is going to hear about for probably close to 2 months, maybe three. On the blackboard, I don't know if you guys ever pause the video or zoom in or anything. I erase it almost every other day, but my next 30 videos are planned out. One of the things we're going to talk about in the live stream is the new building. It's happening. The second thing we're going to talk about is what's going in the building. You benefit. I'm excited about it. The third thing I want to talk about is the layout of the tanks, what we're actually doing with it. And then finally, I want to talk about what's going on with these tanks. So if you're not a member of the channel, the members already saw like everything, like unboxings, or it wasn't unboxings, it was like after the fact, already unboxed it and stuff. But these tanks are just housing these fish for now. I think we should talk about a lot of things. I think that you guys will have to remind me if I didn't touch base on all of it, but this is all, this will, if I say what I'm about to say after I'm done building this tank, no, when the next portion is curing, it will ruin my videos. It burns them for 3 months. Burning meaning you don't even need to watch them. Oh, you can watch them to see exactly what I did and to visualize it and that sort of thing, but I'm gonna do it. I think I'm gonna do it.
Enormous catfish, $5. Apple juice. Chili Will's Reef, $5. Hi Joey, have been watching you forever. You are one of my favorite. What else?
One of? Who's the other ones?
Super Chat, Bill Ham Breshit, $2. $20? I'll go back to this. Anna's Hobbies, $5. Been watching since 2016. You helped me begin my hobby. I met you at the first Dallas Aquashella. You rock.
Yeah, 2016 is what? 4, 7 years ago. Let's go check out Anna's Hobbies channel.
Preston Ryan, $9.99. Show us Frank or an update on him while we wait for it to dry. And oh, also, could you show us
subscribers.
Some of the tools you're using
she's
for the job?
Now gonna have 448. Refresh. Oh, I wonder if the chat can get her to 500. She only needs 52 more. It's called Anna's Hobbies. That would be fun. That would be important. That would be special for her. She's got... Oh, she hasn't made videos for 3 years, so... Anna, sorry. I don't think... You have to have a reason for people to subscribe. If you haven't been making videos for 3 damn years, there's no reason to do it. Never mind, I take it back. 500 reviews, subscribe to my channel. I need more. I need everybody. All right, let's move along. So as you can tell, when it comes to an acrylic aquarium, I could probably build them a heck of a lot faster than I am. In fact, I have. All the tanks on the floor right here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I built those in the same 24-hour period. And the reason being is simple. I usually build one tank at a time. I usually take my time. I'm usually scared I'm going to mess something up. And I take it as serious as a heart attack. And then I started building them more often. It's one thing to build a tank every few years, or, you know, I built cement, I built glass, I built acrylic, I built plywood, I built plywood and glass. I've taken glass tanks apart, cut them up, and turned them into new shapes. But you only kind of do that once. But if you do things over and over and over again, you just have so much more confidence and such a more better understanding of things.
Super Chat, Kyle Worley, $4.99, new subscriber here, excited to learn. Now I'm thinking I need to build an acrylic tank.
So, I'm going to push this out of the way enough to to get the bottom panel on. So we started off by putting one side panel on, then we put the other side panel on. We flipped it over, we put the back or the front panel. And when it comes to like what should be the back and what should be the front, that's up to you, whichever one turns out better, whichever one's nicer. I also don't worry about if it's perfectly great, because what I'll do is I'll take a flute and play a song for it. No, a flute drill bit, router bit, they're called flutes. So they'll allow me to shave off and make this flat. Because if you come around the side here, you can kind of see the glue sticking out. So if I didn't have a router, I would just scrape this off with a razor blade. Well, watch this. A couple passes with that and I can clean it up, but, and or the torch. So we'll use a map gas or propane gas works as well, torch, to remove and or polish the edges to make them look literally seamless.
Super chat, Anthony Leake, $4.99. Hey Joey, been watching you since the 370 plywood tank and also been OnlyFin member for a year or two. You are my absolute favorite YouTuber.
Appreciate it. But let me give you something to appreciate. Come on in and check out how perfect my seam is. I don't see an air bubble. Can we come over here and look at this? This is, and you're gonna get mad, Tamara, but it's more beautiful than Tamara. Which arguably isn't that hard, but just joking. Please don't leave me.
Super chat, Chili Wills Reef, $5. Okay, Joey, you are the best DIY ever, but I did like you and Rico's going at it.
Me and who?
Rico.
Going at it?
That's what he said.
I don't know what that means.
Super chat, Nolan Carter, $4.99. Love to see you keep monsters in the future. Red tail cats and some other monsters. Maybe even grow out.
We have a red
some new arrows growing. Would be nice.
We have a red tail cat growing
to watch,
right,
I believe.
Now. It's in the 375. The one or the 2000, and I'm not completely sold on the idea of it. I'm putting the red tail in the 2000. The Asian arrow one is going to stay in. All other fish are coming out. The ostriches are going in here. That makes far more sense. The frontosa. And again, I don't mean to keep bringing up the numbers, but they know why the frontosa are going in the bottom tank. And then this tank is something abundantly different, but... No, I can talk about it right now. There's a fish that I've never kept. There is also a fish that I've always wanted. That same fish terrifies me. And I don't mean that it's dangerous and it's crazy. I mean that it has such a reputation of being sensitive, difficult to keep. And Lord knows it's damn expensive. Yet so rare that you hardly ever, if ever, I've never seen them in person. That's how rare they are. I don't see them on lists, and I have access to lists in every continent on the planet. I found them. The reason my channel exists is because I got the wish version of that fish. It's happening, and I'm scared, I'm a little nervous, I'm worried, I'm scared I'm not gonna like them as much as, I'm not worried I can't keep them alive. I'm scared that I'll build up hype around these fish, and then you guys won't like them, but ultimately, and I don't mean to be rude or hurt your feelings or whatever, but don't care. I gotta do it. I have to do it. And once you hear the whole story, and once I tell you exactly what they are, you're going to know, you're going to understand. Will you get them? No. Absolutely not. But will you enjoy this story, and will you enjoy watching my journey with them? I thoroughly believe so. Do I need you to? No. So, this is the problem with building larger tanks and longer tanks. It's not a huge issue, but the gap, and I don't know if you'll be able to capture it on camera, but the gap here is greater than the gap that the pins are creating. So what that means to me is when I release this pin, this isn't going to press together the same. So I gotta close that gap a little bit. And what I'll do, is I'm gonna take a couple like little razor blades and we're gonna shim it. Just gonna shove it under there if I can get them in. Just to close it ever so slightly, and now it's perfect. Now, if I do a 4-foot tank, I'm going to need thicker shims because everything bows, especially if it's suspended. And when it comes to even bigger tanks, like when I built the 375, I used literal wooden shims to push up the bow in order to make contact. So again, all prep work.
Super chat, D Hardy, $2, battle for your attention. Us Twitchers are lonely.
What?
Battle for your attention. Us Twitchers are lonely.
Oh shoot, no, on Twitch somebody said what it was. That's a conversation that I'd like to have with that person. TentyV1. Wow. They've done a couple of things. They said pig-nosed turtle. I've had pig-nosed turtles in the past before it was like trending to do on YouTube and everybody's like capitalizing off of it and thinking it's, I did them like 10, 12 years ago. Not to be like, you know, remember the people that used to like do something before everybody else? Like, what was the word you called it? You don't hear that word anymore.
Like a trendsetter?
No.
I don't know what you mean.
I don't know, maybe somebody in chat will know what I'm talking about, but not to be like that, like not to be like, oh yeah, that's so old, I've been doing that.
Pioneers? OGs?
No,
influencer?
OGs. Huh?
Influencer?
No. No.
High
those
speed.
Are calm,
Trailblazer?
No. Huh? No.
Trailblazer?
No.
Lots of guesses, but no one knows.
I forget the name, but once I remember it, you're gonna laugh. Because you're going to be like, yeah, that's exactly.
Hipster?
Hipster! Yeah, see, that's what I was just trying to be like, you know, before it was cool and trendy, I was keeping pig-nosed turtles. Now it's funny, but it wasn't funny at the time. I think hipster is right. Yeah, you guys got it. All right, so now I got to squirt this all around the perimeter. And hope that I have enough cement in this. Because doing a massive perimeter, I don't think I have enough cement in this. I might not. I mean, I'm overusing it. Oh man, what a cool view. I think my live videos are better than my recorded videos because usually my recorded videos are just like whatever camera angle I set it at. So I don't recommend starting over from another side and meeting them. My arm is just uncomfortable. Twitch got the words immediately. They're my Twitchsters. They got hipsters first, and now they have become my Twitchsters. I don't know what to call them. I don't know how to do it, but Ray from Twitch, who's my manager, I guess, he's been like telling me like how to do Twitch and stuff. And on Tuesday we have a call and we're gonna go over a bunch of stuff. Because Twitch is a different audience. It's not even a different audience. They just talk differently. They interact differently. Everything's like a little different. And I really enjoy it. I really like it. But I just don't know how to do it. But Ray's gonna teach me.
I'm gonna teach you the ways.
Yeah, he said, you wanna F around? You're gonna find out. No, so I'm just gonna talk, and obviously I need better internet and better equipment and stuff, but I think for the majority of it, I just need better internet. What's going on here? So that's why I don't like using this little bottle applicator, because we're already 60 seconds in and everything we did is already like drying. This seems really bad. I can fix it, but this applicator doesn't squirt the acrylic out fast enough to do, what do we got, 3, 6, 7, 8 square feet, 9 square feet. But whatever, it's what I have.
Super chat.
I'm busy!
Morthurus Mort, $9.99, love what you do, keep doing you.
Thank you, I appreciate it. What's her name?
Morthurus Mort.
Okay. You can't say it, I'm not gonna remember it.
I'm not sure if I pronounced it correctly.
I don't think it's a good idea for me to go live on Twitch and YouTube because one of them has to be abused. One of them's not going to get a good view. And right now it's been like Twitch.
We're not abusing you. Now I need to get down off my stool.
Please do. I think this live is more so behind the scenes because when I do lives by myself, especially on YouTube, it's far more like YouTube Joey, where it's my customer service voice type of deal. Right, this has to come out. This seam is really bad here, and I want it to fix itself. Do you see that? Ooh, that was nice. You don't have to try to get to every seam.
They just must see everything.
Stay mostly stationary.
Sue Ann, $2. Love the lives, Joey. Thank you.
You're welcome. Just know that I actually do build these fish tanks. These aren't highly edited and rehearsed or voiceovers. When I teach you to do something, I teach it based off of like actual experience, and I've done them over and over again. But what I'm doing right now is there's a little bit of acrylic didn't reach a couple of the seams, and mostly just like on the edge, so I'm just adding to it. But I was most concerned about this seam, and I fixed it. So now I put some more weight on it. If your seams are kind of bubbly and or not doing that great, put some weight on it. Usually I do clamps. I do the big bar clamps, but it's not necessarily all you can do. All right. So now one of the things that I'm not going to be able to do in this stream, we still have working time. You can technically still move this stuff around and fix it. It'll slide around a little bit. It's like gooey. But you don't want to do that too late in the build. But that's it. Tank is done. Obviously, I need to do some routing. I need to do... I just dropped a needle on the ground. That's lovely. Got it. I need to do some routing. I gotta route off some of the edges and whatnot. I have to flame polish, but most importantly, the next step is bracing it. And the bracing, these are technically the braces for the 4 foot long versions and whatnot. So I'll do the bracing another day. I'm gonna brace them all in the same day and then route them all in the same day and flame polish all in the same day. And that'll be a regular YouTube video. I won't go live for that. It's just too messy. It's gotta be done outside with a shop vac. Acrylic is not biodegradable, so if you're ever routing it or anything, you have to throw the materials out. It can be recycled, but you shouldn't do it outside thinking that the wind's gonna take it away. Oh, it will, but it's not biodegradable, so it's gonna exist essentially forever. Alrighty, now we gotta talk about what we're doing. Before I get into all the news and announcements, I think what I might do is catch up on some chat. I'm here for you, Twitch. Looking at the chat. Oh, I guess we can go here. It's not a huge delay. This is AI Joey. Corona is not my flavor. Some people like it, some people don't. I tend to drink a bunch of different types. I like coffee flavored. I do like different types of things and whatnot, but. Keep Tamara up on a pedestal. Is Joey going to Reefapalooza in New York? No. No more conventions for me. Club events, hobbyist level stuff, only moving forward. Okay.
Do you want to put that facing you so that you can see the chat for you too?
Victoria. Well, I never got to meet her yet, but thank you for always taking through risks so we don't have to. Your projects help us all. Aquascaper from Chicago, Illinois. You a fan of sours? I don't mind some of them. I is the big fish in Maryland. I was at the big fish deal in Maryland. Joey and Tamara, it's Xavier. How are you guys?
That's my littlest cousin. Hi, Xavier.
Oh, what's up, my friend? Hope to see you again maybe this summer. When are they coming back?
Hopefully this summer. They usually come every summer.
That's pretty great. Yeah, I like them. They're good boys. Good, good. He's a good man.
He's a good man, Savannah.
He's a good man, Savannah. A good, good man. Yeah, those kids are there. We miss Frank, yeah. Alright, let's figure out. Oh, now that, like, the initial hype is gone, I regret saying what I said I would do on the live. Pause the live. I have to have a side conversation. YouTube, pause the live. Is it like Google or Alexa?
I don't think so.
No, I said it. I'll do it. All right. Well, we've been live for an hour and a half, 99 minutes. Thank you for all the likes, ladies and gentlemen. You got up to 750 exactly. 751. Wow, thank you. What's the best... Tariqa asks, what's the best beginner fish you would personally recommend for someone wanting to experience the hobby? So, we need 1,000 likes, Daniel says. Yeah, I agree. So, Experienced hobbyists hate when I say this because a lot of the times when I talk about this, the newer hobbyists think that they can rely on this fish and think that they don't have to do the work or the water changes or have a established biological filter. But in my opinion, I think that you should lean towards labyrinth fish simply because they can breathe or at least take in oxygen from the surface. They have that labyrinth organ in the back of their head. Fish that qualify, unfortunately, are the beta, types of gourami. I mean, you can go crazy and get a bicher. Oh, geez. I think that goldfish are probably one of the worst. I think that if you just watch my older videos and or go through some videos where I talk about how to establish your tank, how to the nitrogen cycle, why you should be doing as I do, you'll be successful. I have to make a video about this eventually. Okay, Tamara's gonna cover the chat for a second, and it'll be interesting to see. Joey, loving the lies. Is there any worry about drips or squeeze out of the cement on the acrylic? Yeah. If you make a mess of the acrylic, leave it alone. It's far easier to work with after the fact than during. So if the acrylic drips out cement and it dries white, you add more acrylic onto it and then it dries it clear, or you can just like flame polish it away. It's not that big of a deal.
Twitch are feeling abandoned again.
I know. That's why I said you got to do this for a second. I'll do Twitch. Guys, I'm sorry. Abandoned again. I started with betas. I also started with beta.
Any thoughts on a cichlid community tank?
What do they mean?
What do you mean?
Like a multitude of, like a bunch of different types of cichlids? I've done them, yeah, they're fun.
What if you make a mess with black silicone on a glass
DJ Dilemma.
Tank.
So let's talk XYZ. Shut your whole mouth. How's that sound? Because we're not ruining surprises today, are we? You're not a good man, Savannah.
Thank you, Victoria. Joey, you stay on Twitch. We'll keep Tamara. Any event in BC? When are you coming back to the UK again, Joey?
I'm going where people actually book. A lot of clubs and things wanted me to announce them and say that I'm coming, but then never book the tickets. On May 12th, May 13th, something like that. Well, you just check my Facebook or Instagram, but I'll be in Atlanta, Georgia. To come and talk to you guys. And then that's going to be like a really, because the largest aquarium in North America is there. So I'm excited about that. You guys have always said, you got to go. Well, I'm going. And we're going to figure things out. We're going to get my first impressions and I'm going to show you things from a point of view that I would like you to see it from, which is precisely mine. I think my point of view is so much better than everybody else's.
POV, Joey.
Yeah. I look at things as a fish keeper does, as opposed to a tourist or somebody trying to capture everything. I just like the way I do my tours of aquariums. I do. I watch them sometimes. I'm like, man, I got to go back. The next one that's booked, I'm supposed to be in California for June. There's no tickets booked for me. So we'll see what happens there. April was supposed to be Sweden, then it was supposed to be Rhode Island, then, you know, they all flaked. September is Calgary, Alberta. If I'm coming anywhere close to you, within like a 4 to 6 hour drive, come, because the odds of me coming back are slim to none. I don't know if I'm traveling anymore for clubs or anything after this year. It's unlikely. But we'll see, especially for like free It's very hard for me to travel. I'm not a fan of it. I'm coming for you guys. I'm coming to promote the hobby. I'm coming to like reset why we have a hobby. I think it's incredibly important that we support it at its grassroots. Otherwise, we won't have one. Because without aquarium clubs and without your local fish stores, we literally do not have a hobby. I think that people in my position should open their eyes, give their head a shake, leave their ego at the door, and go to the clubs again. I figured I will lead by example. I don't want to go to big conventions anymore. Yeah, you guys got to come to me. I'm coming as close as I can. So if I'm a state over or two states over, just make the trip. I'm coming from a very long ways, so you got to come see me. All right.
You can handle chat for like, we'll do banter for 10 minutes and then we're going to do tours and announcements. Okay. Can they hear me?
Can you guys still
hear? We'll do banter and small talk for another 5-10 minutes and then we're going to do tours and announcements. Jacqueline, he's going to Calgary. Yes, in September. June is supposed to be Sacramento and San Francisco. I say Calgary because the flights are booked, the hotel's booked. I say Atlanta, Georgia on May 13th or whatever it is, because flights are booked, hotel is booked. I say California in June because it's scheduled, but nothing's booked. So, all right, 5-10 more minutes of banter, and then we're gonna do announcements and walk you through some stuff. But Tamara has to run you guys. I gotta get back to Twitch. These guys are gonna throw a riot. 143 total sub points. How many followers? Did we hit the 21, 22?
How about coming to Brazil?
I would do Brazil, yeah. But only clubs.
How do I feel about Joey's custom beer poster? He wanted me to make one of those for him, but I never got on to doing it, so he just took it upon himself and made his own, and I don't mind at all. I think it's great.
She is not a fan of it because it was during her chubby phase, but I didn't notice she was in a chubby phase, and I like it, and that's not my fault. I gave her plenty of heads up, and I wanted her to do it for like a year or two because we were seeing them on TikTok and stuff, and I was like, do a poster, and she didn't do the poster. So I did the poster. And like, okay, can we really actually look at it and tell me this is chubby phase? Girls are so hard on themselves. Like, man, if we like you, we like you. Yeah, there she is. There's my chubby little monkey. So ridiculous. Looks good to me. Whatever. I guess that I have incredibly low standards, though.
Hi, everyone. I just over here because they were like, he abandoned us again.
All right, I'll do YouTube and you can do Twitch. I need one. They're not sell merch. Did you get my super chat? Did you get all the super chats tomorrow?
I think so. I feel like I did. He keeps heading out to get milk.
Who?
Who's the only other bee?
If Joey's a fish, what fish would he be? Probably be a Corydora. Because I would certainly be a bottom eater. No. I would be an Asian arowana. Everything is the fish everybody wants, but not everybody can have. They're elusive. They're gorgeous. They typically do best on their own. They're majestic. They're the reincarnation of the dragon. I think I would be an Asian arowana. But I wouldn't follow through with like a lot of the beliefs of like Asian arowana jumping out for the owner. I wouldn't do that for my owner. Like, I'm not gonna die for you, like literally, because you had a bad week. But that's what Asian culture depicts and talks about. We miss Buddy. If Tamara was a fish, what would she be?
Something beautiful.
Tuna. Tuna fish. No, probably like a trout.
I don't
like a sardine or something.
That would be
a koi. A koi. Yeah, beautiful koi. Well, koi tend to be some of the most expensive fish on the planet. You are pretty expensive. A mermaid. A Moorish idol.
I would be a mermaid.
Jack Dempsey's cichlid. Are you going to get one? No, I've had them before. Obviously, the Jack Dempsey was named after the boxer. But I do think there are other cichlids that are far more tenacious and aggressive than the Jack Dempsey. I think the Jack Dempsey is relatively calm. I think the Electric Blue is an incredibly beautiful Jack Dempsey. I'm just not a fan of them in general. I think I don't like their body shape or something. I think that is very basic. I appreciate them, and I've kept them in the past, but there's other things that I like. I can't keep everything. I want to have everything, but I can't. Okay. So I think we're going to wind down here and talk about announcements and things like that. But I'm going to have to delete this live after I talk about it. Because I'm not, it's not even close to being ready.
Hear it now or hear
it never. All right. Visiting anywhere near Pennsylvania. Yeah, Atlanta, Georgia. That's it. That's about as close.
Fuzzy343, if someone told me that they didn't like my body shape because it was basic, I'd be heartbroken. Ha 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 ha.
Okay, Freddy's back. I'm here.
He's got to go again.
And then I'm going to do the announcement.
Buck Wild, $20. Are there any public fish gallery plans in the future? Not now.
Kind of, but 2-3 years from now. But it's not what you think. It's better. I need time.
One fish you have always wanted but never kept.
It's coming. I found it. Twitch ruined it. Yeah, there's definitely one, but there's a person on Twitch that guessed it, and if they continue to say what it is, I'm deleting Twitch. Just know that. I wish I remembered their name. They might pop up in a second, but they said the exact fish, and I don't even know. So after this live stream, I'm going to have to talk to them. I'm going to have to figure out how they know or why they know, or like how they figured it out. Am I that obvious? Is it that obvious?
You look like you're under a little shelter.
Huh?
You look like you're like under a little roof.
It is. Looks like I have no hair. I have hair. Just not a lot left. That's why I tried to grow it. I was like, man, I'm losing my hair. My hairline's terrified of my face these days. Once I started growing hair, I was like, am I doing a comb over?
were, and I didn't really know what was going on, but I also was like, maybe that's the look he's going for, so I didn't really critique it, I guess. He wants a man bun? No, he does not want a man bun. He won't be having a man bun. The only buns around here are mine.
Tamara!
What? Are y'all
on YouTube?
I'm talking about my hair!
Oh.
Are y'all together? Yes, we are engaged. Great, we made him run to get more apple juice. Yes, sir. What's my favorite fish? Well, it changes all the time. Right now, my favorite is, I said it already, the koi right here. This one coming by.
I'll cover the questions. Are you guys together? Not after tonight. Was the talk about your buns?
Somebody said buns? Something about you having a man bun, and I said, he's not having a bun. The only buns around here is mine, and I pointed at my hair.
Oh, I thought you were being inappropriate.
No, I didn't have my mind in the gutter like
I still want to break up.
It is a top knot. It's a top messy bun kind of night.
First
time
chatter. So the blah blah blah. I hate it. So Tamara is available.
No.
Yes.
I'm not tonight. I am not.
She comes with a free poster.
A free poster. How much for the poster?
Okay, we have to move on.
Moving on.
Chat's moving slow. Twitch is gonna hate me. Because I'm going to move the phone around, and they don't get to come with me.
Oh, it's faced at me. Why is it all greasy looking?
Because I'm greasy.
I almost have as many chins as Frank had. Look at that.
Announcement time.
Frank would be proud. Joey is a lucky man. Is it luck, or did... Actually, just to prove a point... Tamara, you're here on your own free will, right?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
I thought she was gonna go. So first and foremost, we have to take a look at the way the tanks look once they're set up. Will you have a huge backyard pond? Potentially, something's coming. So this is one of the 4 foots. This is the cube. This is the size we just built. So when all of this looks small, I want you to consider that this, and look at the width, look at the girth on this. 16 inches is 16 inches tall. I like 16 inches tall simply because not a lot of light penetration is needed to grow plants. You don't need incredibly powerful lighting. I like the 16 inches of width because most tanks are 12 inches, and that's true. And if you had a 36 inch by 12 inch by 16 inch tanks, there's not a whole lot you could do with them, but 16 by 16, the doors are just flooded with opportunity. 48 inch, 16 inch, 32 inch, 48 inch. That's exactly how they're gonna be lined up, except two stacks. It's supposed to be 9 tanks, but we're doing only 8. You'll understand in a moment. This is a 40-gallon breeder tank. These tanks will be pushed in more, but this is going to be the saltwater sump, and on top of it will be the freshwater sump, because the bottom rack, and I'm entirely and completely sold on it, is going to be saltwater. The top will be freshwater. Now, this is where I need you guys to put on your tinfoil hats, your imagination caps, or whatever you gotta wear in order to like follow me along through this idea. Imagine for a moment that I set up a 32 gallon aquarium, and it doesn't necessarily mean that that's exactly the fish that I'm going to do. I'm gonna give you examples. If I did a 32 gallon aquarium with a bunch of tangled manzanita, tangled throughout the tank. Oh, and every tank is drilled, 3D background, substrate, all of them scaped, all of them beautiful. But imagine if we did, in the 32, tangled manzanita. Obviously, it's not gonna look like this, but you get the idea. And we jammed, not jammed, but like, we have 50 cardinal tetras in it. What would be the equivalent directly below it for salt water?
Emperor angel, you are correct.
What would that be?
Next to my other thing,
green chromis? Who does a green chromis tank? Isn't that an interesting thought where you have a salt water or fresh water and then you try to emulate it and or compare it to salt water? Why can't, mind you, I am a little biased, and I will want to do certain types of fish that I... What if in the cubes we do shrimp? Saltwater, freshwater? What about predators? What about... There's a tremendous amount of interesting things that I want to do. What would be equivalent to, let's say, and I want to do it again, an anemone troop with a bunch of, clownfish troop with a bunch of anemones again? 20 clownfish, 15 clownfish? What would be equivalent to that? What would be equivalent to that? What kind of interacts and acts the way they do? What's almost similar to them? Is it trophies? These are fascinating aquariums and questions that I have. Mind you, this is only 8 tanks. Tomorrow, you guys will see. I'm going to give you a sneak peek. Tomorrow, well, these have been here for 3 weeks, but that's 8 tanks. And then we get to play. Then we're playing. Then we're going to have fun. Oh, then we're getting nasty. Oh, clownfish versus loaches. I think a lot of loaches get relatively big, but maybe we could do some yo-yos. Or maybe some coolies. Oh, shoot. Coolie loaches versus clownfish. I'm not giving you credit for that. That's my idea. I came up with it. You said loaches. You didn't say coolie loaches. I said that. So technically, I don't even have to say your name in the video. I'll say it in live, but not clown gobies. So we got 12 15-gallon tanks. They're not huge, but we are. Well, I'm going to tell you what I'm doing. All of this is in tomorrow's video. Ooh, I got some sun today. I think I'm burnt. This is one of the 15-gallon tanks. You will see it from this angle, front to back. You're not going to see it from this. I don't have enough space. Not for 12 of them because they're 2 feet long. Front to back. The back 3 inches is going to be the filter. We'll be doing the Hamburg Matten filter. You guys seen me make that video 9, 10, 11 years ago, something like that. All the materials, I have everything ready to rock and roll. But what fish do we put in them? I think some of them should be quarantined. I think some of them, because they're all freestanding, they're all standalone systems. They're not tied into each other. I think some could be quarantined. I think some could be grow outs. I also think some should be breeding tanks. I think that one of the things that we should do, I want to get into fancy plecos. Man, tomorrow you guys are going to hear the plans. What else was I supposed to talk about tonight? We'll have to do it over here.
They want to know what you have been talking about too.
Go over it all over again?
Well, I didn't know if you're going to or not.
What was the 3 announcements or 4 announcements that I had? Oh, I'm not going to talk about the fish because Twitch already got it, so they can have that. And that was like the biggest thing in my opinion, yet it's technically not even close to the biggest thing. So what I talked about was the 2 racks and what we're doing with them. Essentially, we're going to be going with freshwater on top, saltwater on bottom. And whatever we do in fresh on top with the identical size as to what's below it, we mimic it. And or, I already have ideas for salt, and then the fresh has to try to mimic it in terms of the fish, not the scape, and vice versa. There's certain types of freshwater fish and tanks and stuff I want to do, but then the salt has to do it. Salt versus fresh. That's a bomber idea. Yeah, I like it. So, what is the next thing that I want to do in terms of the new building. What is the actual plans? And you guys here on YouTube as well as Twitch are going to hear it for the first time. Members only, OnlyFans on YouTube already know, and they're, I don't even know why they watch me anymore, because they're just seeing stuff that I talked about a month ago, but whatever, I appreciate their support. If I build a separate building in the backyard, because I don't want to lease, I don't want anything to be in anybody else's hands. I've tried to lease buildings, I've tried to do a lot of things, and it always
backfires.
Completely and entirely backfires on me. Never ends well for me, ends well for them. So, obviously, building in my backyard is obviously probably going to be the better bet, because I'm in full control. But that means essentially duplicating the cost of this building, which is 34 feet by 16 feet, and what I need is 24 by 12. I still have to do a concrete pad. What?
They're like, he took away.
He took Claire away from us. Sorry, Twitch. Well, you can get in this one too.
I don't have any exciting things to say now. It's all on you.
Reef pond, Joe? Maybe, who knows? You got a lot of space. Yeah, so if I build a new building in my backyard, I need a concrete pad, I gotta put up the building, and it has to be up to Canadian code in terms of withstanding our winters, spring, summers, etc. Then I have to run electrical, then I have to run plumbing, then I have a lot I have to do, especially if I go down that road of filling it with tanks. But those tanks would likely just be what we're doing with the 12, 15 gallon breeders. Tamara said the other day, she's like, why don't you just build it onto the side of the house? I was like, well, I'd have to get a certain type of permit for an addition to the house. So I started looking into it. If I don't cut into the house, it's not an addition. It's no more than adding a pergola. It's no different than adding, you know, some sort of a veranda or like some sort of a canopy. You don't necessarily need a permit. I looked at the area that I plan to potentially do that in. It already has electrical. It already has 30 amps of power running to that little section of 24 by 12. It already has lights. And of course, it already has running water. But what would I do with that space? And that's where things get a little crazy. What if I use that space at least for 1 year, make it exclusive, make them numbered, and I build these tanks for you to buy? Only these sizes. You don't want to, though. You don't want to buy a fish tank. Maybe you want to build one, so maybe you buy the kit. That's exciting to me. Maybe I sell the kit. Maybe I sell tanks. People have been asking me to sell tanks forever, and I just didn't want to do it. I didn't want to deal with it. But I've gotten to the point where, like, I want to do something like this. I want to be more embedded in their hobby. And what if it costs as much as a regular fish tank, but it's made of acrylic? What if I could ship to all of North America? Mind you, I'm already going through the logistics. Will it be affordable? Relatively. It'll come at a premium cost. The tank will likely cost more than like a basic glass tank with black trim and a brace. But a Euro-braced acrylic aquarium? Nobody's beating those prices. Because I'll do it next to cost. What if I only do it for 200 tanks and then I switch it over to something else? Because all I need is bigger table space and somewhere to put my saws and stuff. But what if okay, you want the kit, but what if you just want to buy the bare tank? What if you want to buy the tank with a built-in filter? What if it's the tank, the built-in filter, plus a stand? What if it's like, and it can continue to go and go and go and go, and that's exciting to me, but what if we build them all live? I won't say your name, but I'll say the number of the tank that I'm building. And then on the bottom is your engraved number. 1 of 250. 1 of 100. 6 of 100 type deal.
Pretty cool.
That doesn't exist. That doesn't exist. That is the level of, like, collector's edition. Oh, and also, does it come with a warranty? Lifetime. If it breaks, I'll replace it for free. It's not going to break. They're overbuilt. I say lifetime not as a selling point, but out of confidence. Kick it down your driveway when you get it, throw it down the stairs, and then fill it with water and tell me if it broke. It's going to be scratched, but it's not going to be broke.
Don't do that to your tank, please.
I think that is an incredible idea. Mind you, let me run you through something, because if you get one... So it's not like I just came up with this idea. What's prettier? What's sexier? A black trimmed glass tank, black silicone, or like completely clear, nothing there? This is 48 inches, and do the math. 48 inches, or what is 32 inches plus 16 inches? It's 48 inches. So if you get this, you gotta get these to put them under or above it. You gotta have the whole set. That type of stuff is exciting. Would you stop it? This thing was trailing along with me on my feet. That type of stuff doesn't exist in the industry. It doesn't exist in the hobby. I can't build fish tanks for absolutely everybody. I don't think everybody will be able to get one. I don't think I can ship worldwide. But damn, just a few, and to like start some sort of elite group where we all get to see what you did with yours, that's exciting to me. That's fun for me. I think that you would agree. I think that there's a lot of variables and a lot of questions you have, and wait till you see it and let me think, and what's the price, and let me see the finished product, and what's the warranty, and things like that. I get it, yeah. Give me time. But if they're numbered, like, come on. That's no different than asking what. And I don't mean to, because some people don't like them, but like, what color's your Bugatti? Like, imagine if you get 1 of 200. Imagine if you get 199. I would want like 69 of 200 or like 23, like Michael Jordan. I want the greatest of all time. But do they come with a free copy of the book? Yes. Do they come with, if you want to buy the kit, it comes with, you know, all the cement you need, the applicators, the pins, everything. Plus,
like a
plus custom videos. Mind you, these are the things that I think about and that I plan. But that's not the biggest thing that I want to do over the next 5 years. It's an interesting concept. It's something I'm going to do. And I think in a matter of 3 months, we'll hit the ground running. I think that 200 tanks is feasible because I could build 10 a day. We're looking at 20 days of building. I think I only do 200. And I think that, like, I think realistically I should do 500 or 2,000, but I like the idea of, something more limited.
They're saying don't do lifetime guarantee because there's too many scammers.
Oh, I mean, I guess like 1 year guarantee or something. I don't know. Like, I got to think about that. One of the things that I'm not considering or thinking about is the true warranty or what I would guarantee. What I do know is my tanks don't break. You watch me move the 375 around. You watch me do a lot of this stuff. And one of the things you know is my tanks do not break. Yeah, I think it's an interesting idea. Name your price. If I can get a tank, do 500, I need 420. And for the next moment, everyone check out of the couch. You get a tank, and you get a tank. No, this is serious. And you watch me build these things live. I think that's important to know that, you know, maybe the demand is so great. Like, if 200 sell out in a day, some people will be waiting 3 and 4 weeks for their tank. But I jumped ahead of the line, and I can get you these regardless of where you are in North America within 5 days. I have to get the shipping supplies. I have to invest a lot of effing money. If I only do 200, the profits will pay for basically break even after shipping, after all materials, after the building, like to buy the acrylic. A sheet of this stuff is like $400. I can build 2, 1.5 or something like that of the big ones. Like it's a logistical nightmare, but I do believe, and I think you guys will agree, that you should be a part of some sort of an elite group of, if we do 100 or if we do 200 or 300 or whatever it's going to be, that you only exist with those people ever. The general public can't come in, and you share your tanks. Yeah, I love it. I like it a lot. Poster as background. No. I want a 450-gallon. Fill it with reptiles. No, I'm only doing these three sizes because these are the three sizes that I have. And I want to be a part of the group too. You know, get mad as you want, but I want to be a part. Like, I want to have friends that have the same tanks as me and stuff. I think it would be really cool. Need more plecos. They're coming. Set up a site or do pre-orders. What sizes? On Twitch, she says, so you heard the sizes earlier. There'll be 20, 40, and 60 gallon, but you can do the math on your own. It's not technically those sizes. Let me show you something, what I call nano, what I call a cube, first and foremost. This is the nano tank. This is the cube. It's 16 by 16 by 16 inches. It's enormous for a nano cube. I still have to route it, finish it, flame polish, clean it up, that sort of thing. But yeah, absolutely stunning. I love it. Does it hold 20 gallons? No. It holds like 17 or 18 gallons. 16 times 16 times 16 divided by 231, you'll get the gallons. The next size up is 32 by 16 by 16. The next size up is 48 by 16 by 16. But the beautiful part, especially for the people on Twitch that never heard it, is what is 32 plus 16? 48. So you get a 32, you get a 40, you get a 20, and then you get a 60 to go on top. They can fit together. Or maybe you get 3 of the cubes, and you get, maybe you just love cubes, so you just do 6 cubes. I don't know. I just think it's a fun, stackable, fun idea. I think it's incredible. The upside is, which is the downside for me, I'm building all of them. Hands off for everybody except me. If you get something, and if you get a tank from me, it's from me. I built it. I didn't outsource it. I didn't get it from, and I don't mean to throw other YouTubers under the bus, but I didn't get it from Alexi Press or whatever. AliExpress. Or I'm not repackaging, or, you know, I've had opportunities. I've had a tremendous amount of offers. And one of the things they do is like, we're already working with XYZ and XYZ and XYZ. I'm like, I knew they got that from China. Oh, I've been working with this company for years to build a tank. No, you weren't. No, you weren't. I'm tired of people extorting. I'm tired of people extorting hobbyists within the industry and lying and all that stuff. And it's not for me. And hate me, love me. I will never turn my back on you. I will go to war for you. War. And the hobby needs me. Trust me. They need people like me to keep industry leaders scared. And I don't mean like. I do mean physically scared, because I show up and I say, like, don't talk like that on the internet. That they double think stuff, and or I'll make a video, because at the end of the day, a lot of these people know me and they know that I have an extensive background in actually keeping fish. I do know that when it comes to YouTube and videos, I do have to, of course, be a little more flamboyant and try to keep your attention and all that stuff, but yeah. They're great sizes, M. Sully says. Yeah, I like it. I like it. Naughty G boy. Yep. That's exactly who they said. I've been working on this forever. Would you stop? No, you weren't. I know where you got them. I know exactly who gets them. Right? I know how much you're paying. And now I know you're drop shipping, which means they're not even coming from you. Do you like Nick Bingo? I'm not sure who that is. That name's come up a few times. Never really in good light. A lot of people say that I don't like this person or that person. It's never that I don't like the person. It's just that I'm not going to vouch for, and I'm not talking about this Nick guy, because I'm not even completely sure who that is. And he could be a great person as a person, but when it comes to YouTube and stuff, what I will say is that a lot of people make a massive amount of money and they don't care what you think, so they will abuse animals, they'll clickbait, they'll do anything they can for that ad revenue. I will say that the Florida guys have a club, and you know who they are. They call it the 50K a month club. So they're making $50,000 a month off YouTube every month, minimum. So they do not care what you think, what you say, or what you do. But what you won't see is me putting them in my videos. If they're so popular, why won't I collab with them? Because I have integrity. I don't believe in what you're doing. I don't believe in your knowledge or your education. And regardless of how like nice your personality is on camera, I just can't vouch for it. I'm not getting behind it. And that's that. Do I like them as people? Probably nice people. Probably great. Do I believe in their authenticity as well as their integrity? Not so much. I had the opportunities. They all asked, come down, or will you want to do this, that, the other thing? I just ignore them. No. Not that I think I'm better than them, I just think that, man, and I hate saying it all the time, I'm a hobbyist. I'm an aquarium hobbyist. And I was making videos before you could make money. But before that, I was involved in the clubs and I was on the board of directors and vice president and president. I was balls deep in the hobby and I love what we do. And I feel like I have to fight for what we're doing. Nowadays, it's like ROI. I hear fish stores that have channels like calling their viewers their, what's that word called? Where like, their leads. These are my leads. I have the DMs on that. I'm like, man, you are a pretty big channel. You should be calling your viewers leads. So a lead is a sales lead. I just want them to turn them in. I just want to flip them into a customer. Like I'm like, do you think nobody's offered me millions of dollars at one point? No companies have tried to buy me out? I don't do it. I could have did it and I should have did it. I found more validity and more honor in being who I am. And I don't expect everybody to like me, but I do expect you to understand that I have the hobby's best interests at heart. But But I think we've been live for 2.5 hours. I think we should probably end it. I'm going to go live a little bit longer on Twitch. I don't mean to rub people the wrong way. I'm just going to say that I'm sick and tired of feeling sick and tired. As cliche and as horrible and as victim I make myself sound, I'm just like, I'm not a fan of the way things are going. And if I say anything, I'm the bully because I got the bigger channel or whatever the case might be. So I have to lay down and take it, I guess.
I think people need to stop walking on eggshells on the internet.
Yeah.
And in general.
Yeah. ADHD says, just ignore them. No, nobody's like hating on me or anything like that. It's not like people attack me. And I expect, you know, the, you know, people to make videos about me or talk negatively about me. I guess that comes with the territory. And I think that, like, that's an interesting concept because they want to be where I'm at and they want to emulate my videos, but know that I've never made a video about anybody else ever.
People are asking, what's your Twitch handle?
Twitch handle's the king of DIY. It's free to watch. You don't have to, like, subscribe or follow or whatever, but...
Sometimes there's an ad.
Oh, and if you don't... But if you don't subscribe, there's an ad?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. But I gotta get back to those guys over there because they're gonna be pissed soon. So if you're not following me on Twitch, make sure you are. I've signed a contract with Twitch stating I'll stream for a minimum of 20 hours. And I've got like a real support over there where like an actual person talks to me and they're like, maybe you should be live more with your face and your voice and stuff because you can stream your tanks, but you're doing much better. They're just helping me, and I love it. And if I want to talk to somebody at YouTube, it's not going to happen. And when I go live on YouTube, all I have is go live like this, and they can do super chats, but they don't get their names on the screen, and we haven't even explored everything yet. So YouTube's always going to get my videos first, but I think that I'm going to push towards Twitch for going live. I don't like the simultaneous thing. It's really hard.
It's hard to not ignore one or the other.
Yeah, it's really hard because I love YouTube. YouTube's a part of who I am. Twitch isn't.
Mm-hmm.
Twitch is mostly catering towards my personality of where I like to talk and ramble. And that's why I started the podcast. But the problem with the podcast and the problem is like I did a couple of guest interviews. And then I was going to use them as burner episodes, meaning like if I don't have time that week to record our own thing, we'll upload that. But then renovations happened and everything was going on with the yard and stuff and the pond. So we just kept uploading those.
Yeah.
And then now everybody thinks like the podcast has to have guests, but it was never the intention.
Sometimes it's just us that want to have conversation.
1K likes, 6 stones. I think you guys could do, 1K, it's only at 970. 25, 27 more. StreamYard. Yeah, I gotta get to StreamYard. I gotta do a lot of things, man. I'm really busy. It's not that I'm busy. It's like by the time that I want to do internet stuff, like I'm physically exhausted. And it's tough for me to think. And then you'll get this rambling buffoon like me. 1K and pants off. Selvin says, fine. 19 more. Story Lee creates, get the king crowns. Who wears pants? ADHD Victoria. Can we do a fresh brackish water tank that could be transitioned to salt for the rack? Can we do a fresh versus brackish that could be transitioned to salt? Yeah, I think that some archers, some monos, some skates, some... I think that it's just so limited. We hit 1,000. Nice. Thank you for the 1,000 likes, ladies and gentlemen. And everything else in between and outside of it, or... I don't even know what to say about that anymore. Some of you even get upset about that. Yeah, thank you everybody for being here. But, yeah, I'm going to end it on YouTube.
Over to Twitch.
You know, continue on Twitch, and I think that things will get a little messy over there, and as so long as I stay within, I'm not monetized, I'm a partner there. No, I'm verified over there already. Like, Twitch was really helping me. And I, like, I was just, like, petty. I'm like, I don't really want to go to Twitch, because if I want to go live and go live on YouTube, and then I looked at things, and we did, like, trivia night one night, and I was like, well, I can't do that on YouTube. And, like, things, it's, like, certain little things. If a website is designed for something, you should probably do it there. But I was like, well, I'm not verified over there, so I guess I don't want to do it. And they're like, well, just fill this form out, and we'll verify you. I was like, okay.
Can you post the link? I think if you download the app.
Post the link? I don't think, well, I'm on desktop when I look at myself.
If you download Twitch and you look up the King of DIY, you should be able to find it right at the top of the.
I'm in the chat right now. Boop.
Podcast is Aquariums Unfiltered.
Yeah, Aquariums Unfiltered. I think we did about 15, 20 episodes. It garnered over 20,000 subscribers. It became immediately the most popular aquarium podcast on YouTube that's uploaded as an individual entity. And it did really well, but I just, you know, they don't want to do it anymore. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to end it on YouTube now, and then I'm going to do Twitch for a little bit longer, and then Tamara got me some, what are them, T-bones?
They didn't have any, but I got the next best.
What's the next best from T-bone? Still has a bone. So like a rib or something?
Yeah,
what's a steak that's still a...
I don't know. Let me look at the text I sent you.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna have some steak, apparently. I haven't had steak for a long time.
Sterling silver rib.
Oh, it's a rib.
Grilling steak.
We can work with it. I can make it work. Alright. Yeah, Louise got it.
Delicious sides.
Alright, guys, thanks for joining me here on YouTube. We maintained about 1,000 people watching consecutively for the entire thing for the most part, which was pretty encouraging. So perhaps we'll go live again. I like to do lives on Twitch right now and or members only on YouTube because it's not monetized and I don't even think you could super chat and there's a smaller crowd. So if you want to consider helping me, helping the channel, helping the cause, helping what I do, and you know, just getting those warm fuzzy feelings, consider becoming a member of the channel. If you're not a member already, you got a lot of catching up to do. I highly suggest you do it tonight or tomorrow and literally catch up, because I'm not gonna catch you up on my own. I can't backtrack.
Moving on.
But OnlyFans ruins my channel because I never know what I'm talking about anymore because I feel like I've already talked about it, but it wasn't to the general public. It was anyways. Okay, that's it.
Thank you for being here.
All right, say goodbye.
Bye.
Are we still breaking?